Just a few miles outside Brighton and Hove in the village of Fell is Charleston Farmhouse. Charleston Farmhouse was the Sussex retreat of the Bloomsbury Group. And whilst for many, many years their artistic and literary endeavours have been lauded by the arts community, in a sense, their queerness has been hidden away. I'm joined by Mark Richardson from Charleston Farmhouse to talk a little about a new initiative out there at the opening of the new galleries.
That's right, yes. We have some new galleries opening in the newly converted barn at Farmhouse. And one of the things we're trying to do there is to get more people coming along from the LGBTQ communities to celebrate the fantastic work that's been happening there, and to try and get them more involved in the organisation and the way it's run and the way it develops.
So the demographic of your visitor profile, I suspect, has been rather upper middle class and white.
Absolutely, and we're trying to change that now. So my job is to reach out to different communities and to run projects that enable them to come and be part of Charleston and share the magic. The thing about the museum is that it's a great museum, but because it's in the middle of nowhere and because it certainly attracts a certain type of person, I don't think it's being as widely used as a resource as it could be. One of the things that I'm talking to groups about is how the museum can be more useful to them, and I think it was really interesting to think of the museum in that way, to try and find out from communities what they think the museum can offer them as a service. And I think Charleston is now in the mood to listen.
The new galleries are being opened with a new exhibition,
yes,
which celebrates a particular piece of work.
It does. It celebrates the 90th publication of, the 90th birthday of the original publication date of Orlando by Virginia Woolf, herself one of the members of the Bloomsbury Group. And it's an exhibition that looks at Orlando in the present time. So Orlando is about gender fluidity. It's about people changing, if you like, their sex from one day to the next. It's about sleep. And we're looking at that within the context of some modern art as well, some present day art, I should say. Paul Kindersley is going to be doing an installation, and Matt Smith, great artist, bringing the Orlando theme up to the modern day.
And when does the exhibition open?
It opens on the 8th of September, and then it's going to be open regularly every day between 10 and 5 from Wednesdays through to Sundays.
And when does it finish?
That exhibition is a long runner, so it doesn't actually finish till after Christmas. So you
Excellent.
Get a good few months to come along and see it.
And it's not that difficult to get there, because all you have to do is persuade a friend with a car.
Exactly. And we all got friends with cars.
We all have. Thank you so much for coming to Latest TV and talking about it, and good luck with the exhibition and
Thank
the work
you.
Going on there.
Thank you.